Okay, living out the perfected life. Amen? Gusto niyo ba ng perfected life? And we will learn what that means. How do we live out this perfected life? You know, parang we always think, it's so hard to be perfect. And actually, nowadays, baliktad na eh, it's okay not to be perfect. Right? That's already the language, no? You don't have to be perfect. You don't have to be in this certain size or ganitong color, whatever, no? But tonight, we're going to learn what it means to live out a perfected life, no? Not perfect, but perfected. Amen? So our verse comes from Hebrews chapter 12, verses 1 to 2. And for this part, I used the English Standard Version or ESV, and it says, this is a very familiar verse to many of you, if not all. Let me read, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. Looking to Jesus, the founder and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is seated at the right hand of the throne of God." This is what we were singing earlier when Pastor Wen was leading us about the victor's crown. Jesus is wearing the victor's crown. Ano ibig sabihin? Natapos niya. The reason you will get the victor's crown is if you finish the race and you won the race, no? And Jesus finished it for us. So, ano bang background nitong text na to? The writer of Hebrews was addressing Jewish Christians who were at the edge of their faith, no? They loved Jesus, yet life was getting, dapat too, double O, if you can change that, Pearl, too hard, T-O-O, too hard. They were persecuted, ostracized, and even killed. They were tempted to go back to their old way of life, a life that had, quote-unquote, fewer challenges. They were getting discouraged, exhausted, and feeling despair. So, yung audience ni nung writer ng Hebrews, we don't really know who it is, but the writer was speaking to Christians who were Jewish na naging Christian sila. Okay, so they were Jewish and then they became Christian. They believed in Jesus. But during that time, as we know, at the first century, it was very hard. Napakahirap maging Kristiyano. Diba? Pinapatay, pinapakain sa leon. Yung example nga, no, kunwari, oh, nag-fellowship tayo, tapos bukas nabawasan na kayo ng, or the next week, pag nakita kayo, bawas na kayo ng dalawa. Ano nangyari? Ayun, pinakain sa leon yung kapatid ko or yung parang ganon, no? That was their reality. And so, you know, they were, what they call that, I forgot the term, pero they can't go to synagogue anymore. They were parang kicked out, di ba? So wala na silang excommunicated. They didn't have, I think Pastor Chris shared this before, yung wala na silang citizenship in that sense kasi parang persona non grata na sila. So it was getting hard, you know, and if you weren't a member of the synagogue, you couldn't really talk to other people who were members of the synagogue. You could not buy food, you could not transact, you know, economically, napakahirap. So nandun na sila sa edge. Ano ba to? Sabi nila. Ang hirap, no? Ang hirap. And maybe some of you can relate, maybe some of you are experiencing not as the same probably with what the writer of Hebrews were talking to, pero parang ang hirap na. No? Maybe there is something, you're going through something like that. So they were getting discouraged, they were exhausted. No? That was when I was looking it up, no? Looking at some commentaries, the people were exhausted, you know, with what was happening. And when you talk about exhaustion, pagod na pagod ka, parang ayaw mo na, bibigay ka na. Parang ganon, no? So they were getting discouraged, exhausted, and feeling despair. Wala nang hope. Hindi na magbabago yung sitwasyon natin, ganito na talaga, no? The writer was encouraging them about the great cloud of witnesses in chapter 11. Inisa-isa niya, you know, the heroes of faith. And then in chapter 12, he tells them that there is even something better than that great cloud of witnesses na napaka-bilib na bilib tayo. Moses, Abraham, you name it. All of these heroes of faith that we look up to. Wow, ito yung mga gusto nating maging. Yan yung gusto nating anointing, no? Amen? But the writer of Hebrews says, meron pa. Okay? Meron pa. And that's why Jesus is set apart from the great cloud of witnesses. So chapter 11, no? And chapter 12, sabi, there is a great cloud of witnesses, but, sabi niya, we are to fix, aran ba to? Our eyes at Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith life, no? So, aside from the great cloud of witnesses that can inspire us, sabi, merong cut above the rest, and that is Jesus. Fix our eyes, dapat yan, sorry. Fix our eyes at Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith life. More than Moses, more than Joshua, more than, you know, Elijah, more than all these people that we look up to in the Bible, in the Old Testament. No, wow, ang galing talaga nila, we want that. But the writer of Hebrews is saying, apart from them, meron pang mas higit pa. And we are supposed to fix our eyes on Him because He is the author and perfecter of our faith life. Ngayon, ano bang ibig sabihin nun? Di ba? He is the author and perfecter of our faith life. So, let's look into this. Sabi, Jesus is the author and perfecter. Okay? So, unahin natin yung author. Ano ba yun, no? Alam natin, writer, ganyan. So, of course, if there's any doubt, you want to understand what's going on, we go back to the original language and we went to the Greek, archegos, which means originator, author, founder, prince, leader. This is who Jesus is. Siya ang pasimuno nitong buhay natin ng pananampalataya. Amen? The closest thing that we can probably understand it with is Pastor Mina kasi founder siya ng LGI, no? Ganun yung founder, siya yung nagsimula. And Jesus founded this life that we are living. Because He lived it first. Amen? May case siya. Kasi, di ba? Siya yung una eh. So, He is the originator of this system that we find ourselves in. This, in the words of Pastor Chris, this spiritual system of faith that we find ourselves in, no? He is the prince. Alam mo yung prince pala, parang ang ibig rin palang sabihin nun, kasi di ba tayo yung prince parang second. But when you say prince, he is the leader. Kaya pala Jesus, prince of peace, hindi siya yung, ay, second lang, hindi king. Prince means, ikaw ang original. He is the prince of life. Yes, at kaya pala pag prince of peace, hindi yung, ay, parang second, parang, sino ba yung prince? Prince William, parang ganon, kasi may king, ano yung pangalan niya? King Charles. Well, kalimutan ko yung pangalan ng hari. King Charles, na parang, ay, second lang. No, when you say prince, it means he is an originator. Magkaka-synonym po yan. Okay? He is the leader. Siya ang tinitingnan natin. Kaya nga, he is the alpha, the first, and the last perfecter. Let's look at perfecter. And this comes from teleotes. Teleotes. Tama po ba? Teleotes. Okay. Sabi kasi doon, I think may American accent. Yung pagka, ano? The way you pronounce it, teleotes. Parang ganon. Teleotes pala. Ayan. Teleotes. Which means completer, finisher, perfecter, consummator. Anong ibig sabihin noon? Ang ibig sabihin, yung sinimulan niya, siya din ang tatapos. Amen? Yun pala yung author and perfecter of our faith. Yung faith na sinimulan niya sa buhay natin, kaya nga tayo nagkaroon ng ganitong pananampalataya, siya din ang tatapos. Siya ang magpoproseso hanggang dulo. He is the one who will make sure it will be completed. There's other verses in the Bible, no? Like, He is faithful to complete it. Amen? Diba? There's that verse in Philippians that whatever He set out, He is faithful to complete it. He who began a good work is faithful to complete it. Amen? Itong consummator, hindi natin masyadong ginagamit, no? Pero siya yung magtatapos ng proseso. Ang ganda nun, ano? Kasi sometimes what we do is we start, praise God. God began a good work. Okay, ako nang tatapos hanggang dulo. Kakayanin ko na. But what God is saying, no, Jesus is the author and the perfecter. Alpha and Omega. Mula sa simula hanggang sa dulo. It is Jesus. And you know what's great about that? Because it is Jesus, kung anong nangyari kay Jesus, yun din ang mangyayari sa atin. And earlier, Pastor Wen was saying, you know, victor's crown. Amen. If we live this life out, if we live out this perfected life, that is us. That song is also going to be about us because it is Jesus' life in us, mga kapatid. Amen po ba? Jesus displayed and finished a life of faith. Kulang ka ba sa pananampalataya? Parang nanghihina yung loob ko. No? Remember Jesus. He was able to overcome everything and finish the race. O Percy Jesus yon. This is the good news, kapatid. The life of Jesus is in us. Amen? The perfected life is the life that Jesus lived. Yung nabuhay ni Jesus na from the beginning until the end, nung kahit ano pang mangyari, hindi siya na-tempt, he did not sin, no. He was tempted, but he did not sin. Let me read what I'm saying, what I wrote here. He was tempted, yet did not sin. He was killed through death on the cross, yet lived again. He is now seated with the Father in glory. That is the perfected life. Simula, nagsimula kang supernatural, matatapos kang supernatural. Magsimula kang overcomer, matatapos kang overcomer. Magsisimula kang panalo, matatapos kang panalo. Amen? Because Jesus did not lose. When people thought He lost, He actually won the greatest victory. Amen? That is what the perfected life is. Yung buhay ni Jesus, yun yun. Amen? And ito yung good news natin. Tama ba ako? Oh, so scripture, going back to scripture, sabi dito, no, I read this earlier, let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus. Tingnan mo yung buhay ni Jesus, yung perfected life ni Jesus, who for the joy that was set before Him, endured the cross. Maybe you are going through something. You are going through something that you feel like you're enduring. You are carrying a cross. Look to Jesus, and Jesus endured that cross. He even despised the shame. Okay lang. When I was reading, sabi nga, when you die via guillotine, it comes with a lot of shame. If you die, yung chinap yung ulo mo, it comes with a lot more shame. But if you die on a cross, yun yung pinaka parang, pinaka humiliation. And hindi ininda ni Jesus yun. Because now, He is seated at the right hand of the throne of God. When you go through trials and you think you cannot make it to the end, remember Jesus made it. And He is the author and perfecter of your faith. So our good news, ito na talaga. The perfected life is in us. Nasa sa atin. We are not only to follow and copy Jesus' life. Yung parang copy-paste, Lord. Copy. Kaso hindi ko makopy eh. Kasi pag naaasar ako, ayoko na gawin. Tama ba? Si Jesus, kahit ayaw niya, gagawin niya. Para kay Lord. Dahil ganun yung He is, that is the perfected life. Amen? Kahit ayaw mo, gagawin mo. There is a higher cause. There is a higher calling. And you know what he was thinking about? He was thinking of us, isa-isa tayo. In 2024, nandun si Christian Agulto. Kailangan tibayan ko ang loob ko, sabi ni Jesus. Amen po ba? So, ang ganda nito because sabi, di ba, fix your eyes on Jesus. Parang, wow, titingnan ko lang. Gusto ko yun. Parang aspirational. Pero praise God, it is in us. That perfected life. How do I know that? Let's look at these verses. Galatians 2:20. My old self has been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. Hindi na si Ate Ligaya yung nabubuhay, but it is Christ living in her. So I live in this earthly body by trusting in the Son of God. What is trust? That is faith. Believing. Convincing. Who loved me and gave himself for me. Ephesians chapter 3:17. Then Christ will make his home in our hearts as you trust him. Your roots will grow down into God's love and keep you strong. Para bang, anong tawag dyan? Shaky, ano? Naaano ka, nayayanig ka na ba? Well, God said here, it is in the Word, in His Word, that He will keep us strong. Colossians 1, verse 27, for God wanted them to know that the riches and glory of Christ are for you, Gentiles, too. Tayo yon, kasi hindi tayo mga Hudyo. And this is the secret, Christ lives in you. Everybody say, Christ lives in me. This gives you assurance of sharing His glory. Hindi lang si Jesus ang may victor's crown, pati tayo. Why? Kasi na-perfect niya na yung buhay. He lived the perfected life, and that life is what is in us. Through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen? Because remember, Jesus was God with us, Emmanuel, but the Holy Spirit is God in us. The Father is God for us, of course. It is inside of us, that perfected life. And so, sabi dito sa Romans chapter 7, so my dear brothers and sisters, this is the point. You died to the power of the law when you died with Christ. And now, you are united with the one who was raised from the dead. As a result, we can produce a harvest of good deeds. Parang feeling mo, walang maganda na pwedeng lumabas sa akin. Baka sa atin, oo. But the life we live is the life in Christ. And therefore, there are going to be good deeds. No? When we were controlled by our old nature. Sinful desires were at work within us, and the law aroused these evil desires that produced a harvest of sinful deeds, resulting in death. Kung tayo lang, puro sinful deeds. Huwag na tayong maglokohan. Tama po ba? Huwag na tayong, ha? Evil desires. Huwag na tayong, hindi, mabait talaga ako. Alam mo ako, that was my sin. Yeah, I grew up, ang feeling ko, I was a good girl. Yung alam ni Pastor Minyan, kaya sabi ko, walang kwenta yung testimony ko kasi nung bata ako, wala naman akong ginawa talagang super masama, di ba? And that's why I can have the tendency of having a religious spirit. Because I'm not really, alam mo yun, hindi ako yung pariwara talaga. No? I'm not perfect, definitely. But hindi yung, alam mo yun, yung talagang sakit ng ulo, so to speak. Kaya ang feeling ko, pero sa totoo lang ngayon na naisip ko, oo nga, huwag tayong maglukuhan, come on. Diba? Don't even think that you can do it on your own without Jesus. But now we have been released from the law, for we died to it and are no longer captive to its power. Now, sabi dito, we can serve God. You can serve God. You can obey God. You can please God. You can worship Him. Not in the old way of obeying the letter of the law, but in the new way of living in the Spirit. When we live in the Spirit, hallelujah, we can serve God. We can obey God. Even when it hurts. Even when we don't want to. Even when we don't feel like it. But see, it's no longer I who lives. It is Jesus living that perfected life inside of us. Amen? So ngayon, Jesus did not promise a perfect life. Sometimes doon tayo naloloko eh. Feeling natin, but gano'n no, naging Christian ako, doon ako nahirapan. Kasi ang expect natin, perfect life. But actually, what He promised is a perfected life. If we continue on living the life He pioneered, meaning living in the Spirit. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Matatapos ka doon sa kalbaryo mo. Matatapos ka at makakatawid ka. Amen? That's not the end for you. Just like with Jesus, that was not the end of the story. When He was buried, He rose again after 3 days. That is the life that we have. You get knocked down, but you get up again. That is a perfected life. Panalo ka. Kahit talo ka, panalo ka pa din. Amen po ba? Perfected life. Kaya pag tinanong ka, do you want a perfect life? No, I want the perfected life. And actually, I am living the perfected life because of Jesus Christ. Amen? So ngayon, what does a perfected life look like? Okay, so titingnan natin. Hindi ko alam kung mahuhulaan nyo dun sa aking mga graphics dyan. But this is what a perfected life looks like based on Hebrews 12. Number one, a perfected life is living a focused life. Focus, hindi ka sabog. Hindi yung kung saan-saan ka tumitingin. Isa lang. Amen? There is a, I forgot what the summit is. One desire. That was the preaching of Pastor Bernie, right? 2 weeks ago. The one thing, that's right. One thing. Yun yung kay Pastor Bernie. That is what it means to live a focused life. Tingnan natin. In verse 12, this is NLT, we do this by keeping our eyes on Jesus, the champion who initiates and perfects our faith. Ayan, no? Champion. And initiates and perfects our faith. So, the word keeping our eyes is actually aphorao. Tama ba yung pronunciation ko? Aphorao. Okay? And it means to look away from all else. I look away from something else so that I can look at something. Binabaling, tama ba yung term na yun? Inaano mo yung tingin mo, hindi ka kung saan sa, isa lang, tama po ba? Isa lang ang titingnan mo. Laser focus. You are looking away from everything else. You're looking away from fame. You're looking away from wealth. You are looking away. Alam mo yon? Sabi nga, di ba? All these things shall be added unto you if you seek Him first. That's what living a perfected life means. Naka-focus ka lang. There is what we call the crisis of distracted living. This is where you miss out on much of your life because you generally aren't paying attention. You know, that's why nauso yung mindfulness, being present, no? Because andito ka pero yung isip mo nandun na sa bukas, naku yung bills bukas, naku yung mga bata, ano ko yung kakainin nila? Nandun ka na, ang layo mo, or nasa past. Mali pala yung sinabi ko kanina, baka galit sa akin si ano, kasi ganito ganun. You are not in the present, you are distracted. Sabi, you miss out much of your life because you generally aren't paying attention or your attention is so torn in many directions that you really don't focus on anything. Sa dami ng mga ano, hindi, wala na, wala ka nang na-focusan. Kasi una, ito, tas ay, ito pala. Ang ending mo, wala. Wala kang nagawa. Tama? According to Adam Gazzali, our attention defines the way in which we perceive things. Nasaan yung attention mo? Kung nandun yung attention mo, ganun mo rin ma-i-interpret yung mga nangyayari. That's how you will perceive things. So if your attention is, parang sinisiraan ako nitong taong to ah. So kahit na ang sinasabi niya, oy, ano ha, sama ka sa amin. Hindi ka maka, hindi, ang tama sa'yo, nako, gusto niya akong isama para pahiyain ako doon. Because you're interpreting it based on what you're focused on. Yung focus mo yung, gusto akong siraan ito, gusto akong ganito, ganyan. Okay? As another thing, it allows for a degree of control. Kung ano yung focus mo, yun yung control mo. That helps us function. When interferences overload us, sobrang daming distractions, no? We exceed the capabilities of our cognitive control. Sobra na, overload ka na, no? And our important everyday faculties become affected. In other words, distracted living reduces our quality of life. Remember yung message ni Pastor Bernie? Supposedly, yun yung heart, yun yung joy ni Martha eh, to serve. Pero ba't parang hindi siya joyful? Di ba? Asara siya eh. Asara siya na, bakit ganon? Hindi ako tinutulungan. Because yun yung focus niya. Di ba? He was distracted, sabi nga ni Jesus. Those were Jesus' words. Okay? There are 9 distractions, sabi, ever-present distractions that keep us from fully living. This is from Joshua Becker. I found this on the internet. Maybe you can relate with some of them. Not naman all, but maybe some. Number 1, the promise of tomorrow. You're always thinking about tomorrow. Number 2, the pursuit of perfection. I need to be perfect. Sa sobra ng pag ano mo ng perfection, hindi ka na nabuhay. Di ba? Hindi mo na na-experience. Number 3, the regret of yesterday. If only I did this. Sana ganito na lang ginawa ko. Sana ito yung sinabi ko. The accumulation of possessions. There's always more that you can buy. I like. Gusto ko bumili. Sa next sweldo ko, bibili na ako ng iPhone 16. O, di ba? Kailangan lagi akong, lagi akong top. Ano ang tawag doon? Yung pinakabago. Ayun, yung pinakabago. Yan, yun ang gusto ko. Ganon. Gusto ko din nung, alam nyo yung nauuso ngayon? Yung sa Dubai na chocolate, na kanafe. Oh my God, gusto ko din yun. Ganon, ganon. Lahat gusto mo lang. You just want to accumulate more and more. Number 5, the desire for wealth. Some people, you know, their motivation in life is not God, but money. Ito naman, the need for notoriety, I don't think this applies to you. Ang ibig sabihin ng notoriety, yung notorious ka, medyo siga ka, no? Kilala ka, pero in a bad way. Number 7, the pull of comparison. You compare yourself. Ito na naman ako sa example ko. Yung kapatid ko, example lang po yun ha, hindi totoo. Lagi mong kinocompare, bakit yung kapatid ko ganito, bakit ako hindi? Bakit yung katrabaho ko ganito, bakit ako hindi? Always comparing. Number 8, the appeal of pleasure. You just want to feel pleasure. And the presence of indifference. Wala lang, I don't care. So these are things, meron ba sa inyong nakarelate dyan? These are things that can distract us from the one thing, from living that perfected life of having focus on God. How do I know? Remember, Jesus was so focused on the Father's heart. Di ba? Hindi siya ma-distract. Right? Kahit pagod na siya, pag nakita niya, oh no, these people, they look like sheep without a shepherd. Minister siya, kahit pagod na siya. Amen? Why? Because he was so focused on what the Father was. He was so focused on the rescue plan of the Father. Hindi siya pwedeng ma-distract. So focused. Colossians 3, verse 1. Since you have been raised to new life with Christ, set your sights on the realities of heaven, where Christ sits in the place of honor at God's right hand. Think about the things of heaven, not the things of earth. Yun pala, dun pala dapat tayo nakatingin. Kung ano yung heavenly impact. Amen. Because if it has heavenly impact, it will have earthly impact. Amen. Do you agree? Sabi, for you died to this life and your real life is hidden with Christ. Yung totoong buhay mo, yun yung nakakabit kay Kristo. Bakit? Siya gumawa sa'yo eh. Siya nga yung may elaborate plan. Ito yung gagawin niya. Ito yung mga tatapusin niya. That's our real life. Amen? When Christ, and when Christ, who is your life, is revealed to the whole world, you will share in all His glory. Laging may nakalakip na glory kapag kay Jesus. Philippians 4:8, and now, dear brothers and sisters, one final thing. Fix your thoughts on what is true and honorable and right and pure and lovely and admirable. Think about things that are excellent and worthy of praise. Yun daw ang focus dapat natin. Hindi yung kung ano-ano pa. Hindi yung paghihiganti. Right? Amen. Ay, principle number two. Living a disciplined life. If we are living a perfected life, the perfected life of Jesus, it is one characterized by discipline. And you know, maybe some of you, ito yung ayaw nyo. I don't like discipline, maybe, no? Let's go back to the verse, Hebrews 12:5. Have you forgotten the encouraging words God spoke to you as His children? He said, "My child, don't make light of the Lord's discipline and don't give up when He corrects you. For the Lord disciplines those He loves and He punishes each one He accepts as His child. As you endure this divine discipline, remember that God is treating you as His own children. Whoever heard of a child who is never disciplined by its father?" If you were part of my class last Saturday, may ganong klaseng parenting style, no? Hindi dinidisiplina. Pero hindi daw ganon ang style ni God. Ang style ni God, nandidisiplina siya. Amen? If God doesn't discipline you as He does all His children, it means that you are illegitimate and are not really His children at all. Since we respected our earthly fathers who disciplined us, shouldn't we submit even more to the discipline of the Father of our spirits and live forever? For our earthly fathers disciplined us for a few years, doing the best they knew how. But God's discipline is always good for us, so that we may share in His holiness. No discipline is enjoyable while it is happening. It's painful. I want to pause there and I just want to acknowledge and affirm any of you who are feeling the pain of discipline. It is painful. But, there's a but, afterward, there will be a peaceful harvest of right living for those who are trained in this way. Maybe some of you are going through disciplinary action from God. And I wanted to share this, no? This is actually, I found this from the old CLS course. It's from 26 Practical Projects for Parents, ni Betty Chase, written in 1995. But I want to share, there are levels of child discipline. The first level is instruction. Part pala yun ng disiplina. The fact na tinuturuan mo yung anak mo, it means you are disciplining them. It says, to impart knowledge or information, to furnish with direction by modeling, teaching, and commanding, giving orders. Pag tinuruan mo yung anak mo, it's part of discipline. Tinuturuan mo siya ng tama. O, wag kang tatawid ha, pag ganito. My son, no, he's now in grade 3. And mas independent na sila sa school. So I always tell him, okay, this is how you fold your clothes. This is how you wash yourself. This is mga ganun. Kasi kung hindi ko siya tuturuan, pagtatawanan siya. Or kawawa siya. Tama po ba? If you just let the child do what they want, di ano mangyayari? Sila rin ang talo. Tama po ba? So that is a way of disciplining when you instruct. Diba? There are many pastors here. When you teach your people in your churches, that's part of discipline. That's part of love. Okay? So that's level one, instruction. Level two is training. Everybody say training. So the training is to help the child form habits and develop proficiency in areas in which he has been instructed. Para gumaling siya, paulit-ulit yung gagawin. With my son, he had a difficult time tying his shoelaces. No? Medyo hirap siya. Grade 5, grade 3 na siya. Hindi grade 5, grade 3. Anak, kailangan. Nagbabasketball siya, so he needs to tie his shoelaces. Because every time natatanggal, pupunta siya dun sa akin, can you tie my shoelaces? O kaya yung coach nila. You have to. And then, yung drive namin from our house or from my parents' house, going to where he will have his training, nagtatali siya ng sapatos niya. Tapos, again, ginagano ko siya pag mali. Again, do it again. Mom, ganyan. Do it again. O, ngayon, marunong na siya. Pasalamat siya sa nanay niya na pinagtiyagaan siya. Tama po ba? Amen po ba? Training means pinagtiyagaan mo yung anak mo. Diba? Hindi na siya yung parang, I don't know how to. O, tali mo. Sabi kong ganun sa kanya. Tapos, paulit-ulit. O, nakakachamba siya minsan. O, very good. O, gawin mo ulit. Again. Yes, again. Yes, practice makes perfect. Amen po ba? Right? And sometimes God makes you go through these things. He's training you. But Lord, paulit-ulit, training yun. Baka tsumamba ka lang eh. Amen po ba? Di ba yung tsumamba ka lang na, yes Lord, tapos biglang the next time, Lord, ayoko na. Oh, gusto niya, sigurado. Amen. Hindi yung pachamba-chamba, talagang ulitin natin yung si Caleb, no? Again. Mamaya umiiyak na. Oh, I'm tired. No, do it again. Do it again. And I wasn't doing that to punish him. I was doing that because I wanted him to be equipped. Para hindi niya na, can you tie my shoelace? Confident ako kahit saan siya. Pag natanggal yung sintas niya, kaya niyang itali ulit. Amen. I mean, it's such a simple, simple na illustration. Pero that's how it is. Amen po ba? Tinuruan niyo yung anak niyo na magtupi, maglaba, magplancha. Hindi yung iba. May chores yung iba, di ba? Hindi, di ba? Oh my gosh, alam niyo nung I had to go on a mission trip in Thailand. I was still single, no? Siyempre, walang washing machine doon. Laba ka. O di, magayong dito ko. Kasi, oh my gosh, hindi ako marunong maglaba eh. Pero by the time na natapos na ako ng short-term trip, in honor naman ako ng mga teammates ko, wow, marunong ka na maglaba. O, di ba? Kasi pag hindi, ano mangyayari sa'yo? Nganga ka doon. Tapos may time na alala ko, tinatawag na kami nung host. Oh my gosh! Tapos yung friend ko sabi sa akin, tutulungan na kita, parang jeans ata yun. Maong! Oh my gosh! Ang hirap, di ba? Wala. Gawin mo. Amen! Walang brush dun eh. Walang brush. Oh di. Ayun lang. Hindi pwedeng madami kasi may weight limit. Saka bubuhatin mo yun. Hindi ka naman nakaparang hello, I'm here on mission with my trolley. Hindi ganon. Ano ko doon? Backpack ka din doon. Kala mo naman, di ba? Wala eh. Ganon talaga. Amen. Amen po ba? So if you're going through a tough time, Lord, ito na naman ba yung tinuturo mo? God is training you. Amen? IME ka. Ito na naman. Parang IBS lang. God is training you. Because He loves you. Amen? And ito na yung last. Third level of discipline. Correction. Everybody say correction. Ito na. Ito na yung medyo masakit. May ouch factor na. Bakit? To alter or adjust a child's behavior by taking action to cause him to follow previous training and instruction. Hindi mo na-gets eh. Ayun, medyo may spanking, may consequences. Kasi hindi ka nakuha sa training eh. Amen. O dapat lahat tayo training na lang. Tama po ba? Lord, ayoko ng correction. Gusto ko training lang. Extinction. Hindi ko alam ko ba't may extinction. Ano yan from the book eh? Bakit nga extinction, no? Hindi ko napansin. Anyway, going back, amen? Sometimes you need to correct, you need to be corrected. Kasi pa ganun ka na eh. Pariwara ka na eh. Palihis ka na. Balik ka dito, balik ka. Balik ka dun sa training. Tama po ba? And that is love, brothers and sisters. It's tough love, but it's necessary. Amen? Eh, hindi ko to parenting style. This is God's parenting style. Right? Yun yung style niya eh. Sabi niya, una, instruction o tuturuan. On the way you should go. Tapos, okay, ulit-ulitin natin. Pag medyo matigas na yung ulo mo, okay. It's time to correct. Na-extinct na. Okay, nawala na yung extinction. Buti na lang, ang bilis ni Pearl. Okay? Amen po ba? Are we learning? A perfected life is a disciplined life. Hindi pwedeng yung kahit ano gusto mo. Ganun ba yon? Is that a disciplined life? That's a gluttonous life. Yung kung ano lang, sige lang, consume ka lang ng consume. So mo mag-samgyup, samgyup ka. Kahit everyday ka na nagsasamgyup, okay ba yun? Diba? Number one, it's not good for your health, right? Oh. Okay, may mga nagtatawanan na dito. Wala po akong, I have nothing against samgyup, no? Everybody, baka feeling nyo, I'm anti-samgyup. Okay. Alright. Oh, maganda daw training na lang. Wag na yung correction. Kaya, magpakabuti tayo pag tinitrain tayo. Lord, huwag ka na magagaganon. Mamaya, correct ka ni God. Mas masakit yon. Amen? A life that is perfected is you have discipline. Sabi dito, 1 Corinthians 9:20, I discipline my body like an athlete. You know, we just had the Paralympics, kakatapos lang. I think we had, tama ba ako Nathan, the javelin thrower, 4th place, sayang ano, sayang. Tapos yung swimmer natin, butterfly, 5th. Updated. Okay? So we need to be like that. Training, kahit ayaw mo. I read an article about ano, EJ Obiena, and sabi nga daw niya, he wants really to be the best, no, in his sport. And tinatanong daw siya, it was Christmas. Oh, ano, EJ? Siyempre, ano lang to, ha? Abridged. Ano, EJ, what do you want to do? It's Christmas. Tapos sabi daw niya, what is Duplantis doing? Duplantis is number one. So, what do you think he's doing now? He's probably enjoying his Christmas meal, sabi ng coach niya. Sabi niya, okay, let's train. Paskong Pasko, let's train, sabi niya ganun. You need, sabi niya, I need to discipline. I need to be the best that I can be. Tayo ba, that's how we think? I need to be trained. I need to be disciplined so God can bring out the best in me. Or madami tayong ano, spiritual fat. Diba? 2 Timothy 2, verse 3, endure suffering along with me as a good soldier of Christ Jesus. Soldiers don't get tied up in the affairs of civilian life. For then, they cannot please the officer who enlisted them. Who is your focus? Is it the officer, that our leader, Jesus Christ? Or gusto ko lang gawin yung gawin ko. Paisi-isi, petics lang. Or ano pa yung term? Wardy-wardy, something like that, no? Wardy-wardy lang. Or ano ba yung? Pucho-pucho. Bara-bara. Andami na nating ano, no? Okay. So, amen, brothers and sisters. A perfected life is a disciplined life. So maybe some of us need to hear that again. The writer of Hebrews was writing to spiritually weak Christians. They were badly needing spiritual renewal. They were experiencing exhaustion and mental defeat. They were in a state of despair and discouragement. Unfortunately, we cannot advance or grow if we are defeated or discouraged. If you are feeling discouraged, if you are feeling defeated, you cannot grow, you cannot advance. Ang hirap, no? And this was the state of the people that the Hebrews writer was talking to. But praise God, we have the third principle. And the third principle is, when you're living a perfected life, you are living a renewed life. What does renew mean? Meaning you have, it is resumed, it is reestablished, it is revived. Naghihikahos na ba yung iyong pananampalataya? Or parang nandito ka na sa edge? Well, you have a renewed life in Christ. Let's look at this verse and we're about to end. Hebrews 12:12. Therefore, sabi, lift your drooping hands and strengthen your weak knees and make straight paths for your feet so that what is lame may not be put out of joint but rather be healed. Yung healed na word na yan is iyomai. Tama ba ako? Iyomai. Tama ba yun? Iyomai. Okay. Generally, of the physical, sometimes of spiritual disease, healing particularly as supernatural and bringing attention to the Lord Himself as the great physician. This verse really leapt in my heart. Kasi sabi dito, pagod na sila. Pero ang instruction, therefore, lift your drooping hands. Yung parang nanghihina ka na ba? Itaas mo! Sabi ni God, no? Tapos, anuhan mo yung mga tuhod mo? Nanghihina na ba yung tuhod mo? Diretso mo! Parang ganon, no? And make straight paths for your feet. Bakit? Para hindi ma-dislocate, para hindi ka lumpo. No? Ang gustong-gusto ko to dito. So that what is lame, meaning, ano ba yung lame? Parang pilay, no? May not be put out of joint, but rather be healed. So pagka hinayaan mo lang, basically, talagang matatanggal talaga yan. It will be put out of joint. But it's saying, straighten it up. Diba? So that it will be healed. In other versions, take a new grip with your tired hands. Are your hands tired? Sabi, take a new grip. Stand firm on your shaky legs. It's so funny, no? Shaky yung legs, ta sabi, stand firm. Amen? Mark out a straight path, smooth path for your feet so that those who follow you, though weak and lame, will not fall and hurt themselves but become strong. Kung tumitingin sa'yo, para hindi malumpo, dumiretso yung tayo. Sabi, you have become weak. Look at this. I'm in awe of this verse. You have become weak, so make yourselves strong again. Lord, hindi mo ba nakikita? I am weak! Ang sabi ni Lord, so make yourselves strong again. Live in the right way so that you will be saved and your weakness will not cause you to be lost. And in the CEV, stand up straight. Tinan mo to, stop your knees from shaking. Nagagaganon ka na, tumigil ka. Right? Tumigil ka. Diba? And walk a straight path, the lame people will be healed instead of getting worse. Amen? This is the perfected life. Ano ibig sabihin nito? If right now you feel or you know that you are weak, God is saying, make yourself strong again. Paano? Because you are living the perfected life of Jesus in you. Hindi ikaw. Kaya mo yun. You can make yourself strong again through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen? Kaya huwag kawawa naman ako kasi I'm so kawawa, you know, I'm so weak, ganyan, ganyan. Ang taray eh, sabi. Take a new grip. With your tired, pagod ka na? Sige, hawakan mo. Parang ganun eh, no? Parang nangaaway pa eh. Hindi ka tumid maglakad? Ituwid mo. Parang ganun eh, no? What does that mean, brothers and sisters? It means you will be able to lift your hands and strengthen your weak knees. The fact that it's in the Bible, that's my firm belief. It means it can happen and it will happen. Instead of being lame, you will be renewed, healed, and supernatural. Imagine mo, nanginginig na yung tuhod. Umayos ka. Bakit? There's a new life in you, and that is the life of Jesus, the perfected life. Kasi si Jesus, nang hina man siya, hindi siya natalo. Amen? Okay. Yung gusto mo sanang ma-comfort kasi feeling mo weak ka, pero in-straightforward ka ni Lord. Make yourself strong again. Oo nga, no? Sis Melissa. So walk in the opposite spirit, you can do what you think you can't. Why? Bakit nga ulit? The perfected life in us. Amen? Hindi ko na kaya. Mayos ka. Sabi ni Jesus, kaya mo, kaya kayanin mo. It's no longer I who live, but Christ living in me. Amen? Pakita natin sa mundo, it's no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. Yung hindi ko kaya, hindi ko talaga kaya. Pero kaya ko na kasi si Jesus na yung namumuhay sa buhay ko. You have the perfected life of Jesus inside of you. His blood is flowing in your veins. You have His supernatural DNA. So brothers and sisters, this is our summary for today. Living out the perfected life. Not perfect life, but the perfected life. And I don't know about you. Panalo ka sa perfected life. Amen ba? Kasi yung hindi mo kaya, kaya mo eh. Kakayanin mo. Hindi ikaw, si Jesus. So you're going to live a focused life, focus ka lang kay Jesus. Hindi yung parang kung ano-ano pang mga naririnig. Basta focus ka lang. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forevermore. Living a disciplined life, hayaan mo na i-train ka ni God. Hayaan mong i-instruct ka ni God. And even yung masakit, i-correct ka ni God. Wala, lununin mo yun. Kasi pagmamahal ni God yun eh. And last but not the least, you will live a renewed life. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Yung talo ka na, pero nakabangon kang muli. Yung sad-sad ka na, pero bakit? Andito na naman ako! Amen! Because even your weak hands can be raised up. Even your shaking knees can be straightened out. Amen? And you can be healed. In other words, nare-reverse kung ano yung situation mo. Why don't we all stand? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Lord, thank you for the promise of the perfected life. Hallelujah. We know that in this world, there will still be trouble, but we take heart because you have overcome the world. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we want to have focus on you alone. Do not allow us to be distracted by any other thing. Help us to live for that one thing, you alone, Lord Jesus. Help us to embrace the disciplined life. That, Lord, we can't always get what we want, but it is good for us. When you are training us, when you are correcting us, when you are instructing us, it's because you love us. You want us to walk a certain way because you have made and mapped out that life that you have for us. And last, Lord, thank you that we can live a renewed life kahit talo, nananalo pa rin, kahit patay, nabubuhay pa rin, kahit may sakit, gumagaling, amen, kahit walang-wala na, nagkakaroon pa rin, in Jesus' name. Lord, thank you for the perfected life, in Jesus' name, amen and amen.